Hi, I'm Mike from How to Shoot and Edit. Today we show you some advanced tips for the 180 degree shutter rule. To get the most natural looking footage, your shutter speed should be twice the frame rate, which equals a shutter angle of 180 degree. So, theoretically, that is pretty easy, right? If you shoot at 24 frames per second, your shutter speed should be at 1/48 of a second. For 25 frames per second, 1/50 of a second. For 30 frames per second, 1/60 of a second. Now let's take it a bit further. The modern cameras are often able to shoot at 50 frames per second, 60 frames per second, or even 100 or 120 frames per second, or even higher. So, why do we use that frame rate? Yes, we use them to be able to slow the footage down in post. The keyword here is we are able to. Often we don't know if we will slow the footage down or if we will speed ramp it, etc. Let's think about it like that. For example, if we shoot in 50 frames per second and follow the rule, we have the shutter at 1/100th of a second. Now here is what we recommend. If you shoot at 50 frames per second and you don't know for sure that you will slow the footage down to 50%, use 1/50th as your shutter speed. Theoretically, you have a shutter angle of 360 degrees then. But if you are working on a 25p timeline and don't slow it down, you are skipping every second frame and you have your 180 degree shutter rule for the real-time footage again. When you slow the footage down to 50%, you are using every frame and your effective shutter angle is 360 degrees. But two things. First, your footage isn't supposed to look 100% natural anyways, because it is slow motion. Second, 1/50th shutter is in almost every case not too much motion blur to still look good. When you shoot extreme fast movements, like action sports, you should fasten your shutter speed a little bit, of course. So what do we recommend when shooting at 120 frames per second? The same thing. We recommend the shutter to be at 1/120th of a second. This is not too much motion blur for slowing it down to 20% on a 24p timeline. And when you don't slow it down, it is the best you can get, because 1/120th of a second is the maximum shutter speed when you shoot at 120 frames per second. One more advantage is that you get better low light footage by maximizing the shutter speed at higher frame rates, which can be a huge deal when you don't have enough light to work with. So, the conclusion is the following. Shoot at the shutter speed that comes closest to the 180 degree rule when using the footage in real time to get the most natural looking footage. In almost every case, the result still looks good when you slow it down in post. If you've learned something in this video, please subscribe and give us a thumbs up. There will be so much more videos coming in the near future on how to shoot and edit. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video!